A very fine good morning one and all. I welcome you all for the webinar on the topic Cloud Computing using Oracle Fusion. Now I call upon Ms. Sharon Isha, Assistant Professor CSE Department, to spell the God's Prayer.
Dear loving Heavenly Father, we thank you for the wonderful day you have given us. Lord, before the start of this webinar, we are all gathered in your mighty feet for your blessings, guidance and support. Lord, enrich the resource person with your knowledge, so that he will use his potentials fully, Lord. We also pray for the participants, help them to make use of this webinar effectively. Lord, we also pray for all the people who have supported you to conduct this webinar. Bless us and guide us. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Thank you, ma'am. Now I call upon Dr. G. Arun Swaminathan, Associate Professor of CSE Department, to give the welcome address and the chief guest introduction. Sir.
Hello everybody, very good morning to you one and all. It's my immense pleasure to welcome you one and all to this webinar. With a grateful heart to the Lord Almighty, I welcome you one and all who have come for this webinar. First of all, it's my immense pleasure to thank the management of Francis Xavier Engineering College, our chairman and our managing director, for giving this opportunity and the support to conduct this webinar. Also, it's my immense privilege to welcome Dr. K. Jayakumar, the General Manager Development, for all his support, for all his initiative and for all his motivation in conducting this webinars in a grand manner. Also, I welcome Dr. Velmurugan, the Principal of Francis Xavier Engineering College. Also, it's my immense pleasure to welcome my colleague, my comrade, the HOD of CSE Department, Professor P. Brinda, for all her tireless effort in conducting all these webinars. It's my honor to welcome Mr. Arun Prasad, the resource person of this webinar. Also, it's my immense pleasure to welcome my colleagues and comrades of CSE Department. Also, it's my honor to welcome the coordinators of this webinar, Professor Shivakumar and Professor Sharon Isha from Computer Science and Engineering Department, and all the colleagues and comrades of CSE Department in making this webinar a grand success. With these words of welcome, I take the honor of introducing Mr. Arun Prasad Yam, the Associate Consultant of KPMG Global Services, Bangalore, the resource person for this webinar to this August gathering. Sir has completed his MBA from IIT Roorkee in the year 2018. He has completed his BE from Nurul Islam College of Engineering in the year 2010. His academic achievements and certification include Oracle Planning and Collaboration Cloud 2019 Implementation Essentials Certifications, also Oracle Inventory Cloud 2018 Implementation Essentials Certifications, Oracle Procurement Cloud 2018 Implementation Essentials Certifications, Six Sigma Green Belt Certification, Benchmark Six Sigma, Certificate of Recognition for CAA Certified Supply Chain Management Executive, secured second position at the Get Innovate National Level Entrepreneurship Competitions in IIT Mumbai. And his roles and responsibilities include, he's working in Oracle Fusion Product Management Implementation Project, providing cloud-based technology services to the client. And he has worked in Oracle Fusion Procurement internal project, which helps in understanding the cloud-based business case usage of the clients based on US. He has worked in financial analysis and financial forecasting model project, which helped Netherlands client to create a financial analytics repository. And right now he is working with KPMG Global Services, Bangalore. And from July 2018 till date, he is working with KPMG Global Services. And Sir is also a sports person. He is the winner of 20 kilometer cycle race at Exuberant 2017, conducted by Domes at IIT Roorkee. And he's also a half marathon runner, and he's a certified marathon runner from IIT Roorkee 2017. It's a great honor and it's a great privilege to have such an eminent personality in our midst. And on behalf of Computer Science and Engineering Department, Francis Xavier Engineering College, we are so glad to have you, sir, as the resource person for this webinar. And with these words of welcome, I hand over the session to the moderator requesting him to invite our resource person to handle this session. Over to the moderator.
Arun Prasad, sir, present your presentation now.
Thank you, Arun, sir, for the introduction, and thank you, Sir Kumar, for giving me the opportunity. I believe that I'm audible, right?
Yes, sir, you're audible. You can proceed, sir, please.
Just let me know when the screen comes up. Okay.
Yeah, the screen is visible, sir. Your screen is shared.
Yeah. Yeah. So thanks for the self-introduction. As sir stated that, I was working in with the KPMG from 2018 as a financial consultant there. In the job role, I was being a part of a supply chain management Oracle consultant. So that's my core profile in that. Currently, I'm working with the product management for the client who is based on the US. The presentation that I'm going to give here is purely based on my personal experience and the material that's available in World Wide Web. Anybody create a presentation like this. There's no IP that is used, intellectual property of the KPMG or use here. Like it's like a it's currently my personal experience and the perception to that. Next is what is the takeaway from this guest lecture? Since the guest lecture is about cloud computing basics, so the takeaway from the guest lecture will be purely on the basics. What is the cloud computing basics, and what is the Oracle Fusion means, and how the technology can help to find the valuable solutions to the clients. So that is a main motto. Attendees who are in the sessions, from academics from various backgrounds, can understand how your technology knowledge means, how your programming skills, how your coding skills helps to implement the project and smoothing the business for the clients who comes to you. Okay, so this is the kind. So you can utilize this session and the PPT for the further preparation for the interviews for the various organizations. So you can utilize this as a material for the preparation when you have when you're going to face an interview for a firm who do cloud consulting. So then definitely this may be help. This is definitely going to be helpful for you. So based on that, I designed this PPT for that. And it's like more or like, understanding not only about your core skills, like, not only understanding your SQL or Java skills, it's like how you utilize your skills, technology skills that you have learned from the academic to the industry. Like, this may help as a bridge. How the industry works and what you are learning and how can you match up that? And how can listener can build the value, additional value for the technology knowledge they have. So based on that, the PPT is designed. Once again, I thank HOD Brinda and Principal Dr. Velmurugan to give me a chance to present this. These are all the major topics that I'm going to cover. One is cloud computing and another one is ERP. Okay. ERP in generally, I heard in academics, mostly people have been heard that it's nothing but integration management, which smoothens the business using the technology or a software. Right, the software, it may be a software-based service, SaaS, or it may be a platform-based service, PaaS, or else it may be an infrastructure-based services like IaaS. Right, so this mostly the Oracle, that the domain that I am working with, sometimes I use the term Oracle Fusion. That is nothing but the Oracle cloud-based ERP. So we use that term as fusion in the office and other environment. So that is the reason it may be used. So don't get confused with Oracle Fusion. Oracle Fusion is nothing but the ERP resource, Oracle cloud-based ERP. That's all. Okay. So ERP generally helps to enhance the organization's business and the services in a smooth way. Right, especially in a situation like the COVID, where people are people are not going to the offices and trying to work from home, cloud computing is the best way to solve those issues. Starting from a bank, go across to a hospital or to a big core manufacturer, cloud computing helps us them to enhance the business process in a very smooth way, to minimize the resources to come to the offices or a physical form. They can smoothly run the business in the place where they stay, and they can stay good. That's the importance of the cloud computing, especially at this point of a COVID situation. So this has gained a lot of attention throughout the globe already have, you know, the developed nations has already started implementing a lot of cloud computing projects in there, even in the schools, colleges, government institutes and large corporates. And India, it is going to soon come. Still, large corporates in India's, they have utilized this cloud computing in a very well form. So that is the reason, even from the work from home, they can run the business process very smoothly by keeping work from home. Okay. And coming to the ERP, ERP is, I can say, one solution for, I can say, many business process modeling. If you say, as example, as a, we can say, a finance is example, right? If you say finance is example, generally, initial days, consider that, you know, if an organization is going to buy something from a supplier, so they have to pay for them. Like, you buy a product and you pay for them. So they physically go to the bank and, pay that, or else they can give the cash in exchange to get the products, right? So in the, can say, the 20th century era, so those have been automized. So you don't want to, physically give the cash. You can do the bank transaction by going to the bank or whatever it may be, right? So if you want to do this supply chain, then you don't want to, you can mention them through any, through any of the portal. You can send the product to them. Consider that, take Amazon as an example. You order something in Amazon, you pay for them, and Amazon deliver to you. There is no physical interaction between the customer and the Amazon. So how this happens? So this is exactly the ERP do that. It smooths the business. It helps Amazon to buy the product from the third party. It helps Amazon to get orders from the customer, like you and me, and it can deliver to you in the virtual world. Right, so how this happened? They are using the cloud-based ERP. Normally, they use in specific. As I take Amazon example, Amazon use Amazon Web Services as their the ERP for their solving the solution. So this is a brief about the ERP and the cloud computing. And next, if you see the history, you can see that the era before the 20th century. Maybe consider that the time frame of 80s to 2005 or 10, or I can say you don't want to come to that way. From 1980s to, can say, 2000 year, for two decades, electricity is a biggest form of, I can say, a source for all the businesses. If you have the electricity, you can run the business, right? You have the power, to run the machines, and you run the businesses. After that, once that evolution get, I can say, stabilized or saturated at a certain point, then comes the IT solutions came. So that boom started in mostly in USA, and then in parallel in Europe. Then it spread across the world. So same thing, even in the usage of electricity, it was started in Britain or Europe or in US, and then it came to Asian nations, Middle East, everywhere. So same thing, the IT, mostly it has been started by the US firms, and it migrated or travel across through the globe. So from you can say a period of last two decades, from 2000 to 2020, IT solutions or IT business processes are in the trend, you can say that, or it's not it gets saturated, it's a trend, it's growing. And ERP is also one of the part of that IT solutions. Okay, so ERP helps the organizations to build the business process in a very smooth way. So that's what ERP's origin, it date back in 1970s itself. Engineers from IBM, they started building this kind of IT solutions in early 1970s, and the core usage came after 2000. Initially in 2000 to 2010, countries like US and the European countries start utilizing this advantage. Then comes again the Asian, Middle East and the African countries, they start utilizing it. If you ask me or any persons who work in a consultancy or in a consultancy based on the IT solutions, then they can say maybe in 2002 to 2025, artificial intelligence will be maybe in the trend. We are not sure about that, but the predictions as well says that the artificial intelligence are already in the evolution. Like even it starts from, I believe that your academics to have artificial intelligence. It's going to be starting evolving, and in 2025 may be in the trend, along with the IoT, Internet of Things. So these two things enhance not only the business process, but your daily life is easy. So that is the reason these two fields, or maybe in the trend, as like, you know, today if you say that the EOP, cloud and IT solutions are in the trend. So in 2025 to 30, maybe these are all in the trend. And these are all interlinked. Electricity is needed to run a machine or a system. The machine or system runs the solutions, IT solutions or ERP or whatever it may be. And those IT solutions, only cluster of IT solutions form an artificial intelligence. And those, if we give the artificial intelligence to the machines again, then we can call that as a IoT. So this is how the evolution goes. Maybe in the time concern, I was fast. Just let me stop me if I was, you know, going fast or something like that. So this slide is about the global ERP market. Okay. So there are, I can say, if we take ERP as example, there are 500 to, you can say, not more than 500, you can say thousands of organizations all through the globe which use the ERP solutions to any type of organizations, right? So among them all, in the cloud-based platform, I'm telling you the cloud-based platform, Oracle, you can say, tops the list. It holds nearly 10% of the total, cloud-based ERP business in the world, followed by SAP, Workday, Salesforce, JD Edwards. In addition to that, there are a lot of other cloud-based ERPs are there. For example, Microsoft provides cloud-based ERP services. Even Google give the cloud-based services. The best example is they will give a 15 GB of space for your Gmail account. So that's, I can say, a cloud space that you have. So coming to the, can say, if we elaborate more on the cloud-based ERPs, the best thing is, it is as like, you know, you don't want to go to the office to do some operation. You take your machine, laptop, or tab, or a personal computer. As like an account, you have a Gmail, there is a URL be given to you. There is a URL, web-based URL. Go there, unlike logging into your Gmail account, you can log in there, and then you can perform any operation that your business related things will come there. So those slides will be, those slides will come later. So you can see how the screen looks like, how you can navigate through. I know I'm trying to give a glimpse on that. So this is a global order. Coming to India, in India is also, you know, India companies are also providing EOP services. Not only server based ERP, they are also giving cloud based ERP services all through the globe. Tally is one of the, you know, the best, you know, one of the biggest competitor in the ERP market. They provide financial cloud based services to the their clients, and it is one of the, I can say a trademark of a Indian company in the globe. Tally is known even in USA. Its presence is known in Europe. They are well known for their you know, the services, financial services they provide. Even TCS also have their own ERP services named it TCS iOWN. So kind of even Ramco has a ERP service. If you go for them, if you're a small organization, if you go for them, they will provide service for you. So these are some of the ERP markets that is known, just for the information. Yeah, coming to the you know, the comparison, like how the Oracle Cloud ERP services, okay, is compared to other services. What is the, I can say, the importance of that? Since I am working on that, even I know better about this. I'm not much aware of others because I never worked on the platform. But going through their advantages, you can say, Oracle is the only, one to many solution, ERP solution in the world, which gives cross-functionality domain. Cross-functionality domain means, you can manage your entire human resources management in Oracle. You can maintain any of financial resources in Oracle. Okay, so for example, if take an example as Amazon. Amazon has, Amazon delivery boys are there, so they are all related to Amazon, right? Amazon has managers to take care. Amazon has directors to do it. Amazon has partners to take care. So Amazon in the globe, we can say nearly they may have 1 lakh to 2 lakhs amount of human resource with them. So all their payslips, all their salaries, all their database can be managed using this, this ERP like Oracle, right? If you come to other side of in Delhi, I can say I believe it is nearly 10 million of order that Oracle Amazon will receive. So 10 million of order will receive. So 10 million of order management resource, you know, capability that a ERP should have. That Oracle has that capability to handle 10 lakhs, you can say 2 lakhs employees, 10 lakhs, can say order management. Even if you want to go for the marketing, and you know, if you want to market the products all through the world, so it has a capability to market. Even if you want to market your products in 100 countries, and if you want to you know, put your information here, this data management will manage. So that is known as a cross functionality. Cross functionality is nothing but the operations, like, you know, human resource management, supply chain management, or marketing, or sales, or finance, or whatever it may be. So Oracle is a one ERP, cloud-based ERP, which has 130 to 140 functionalities. Compared to other, can say ERPs, they have a limited functionality, max to max 100 to 120. But Oracle has 130 to 140. So that is the reason if the company needs, can say five functionality, for example, functionality means operation is one functionality, human resource is one functionality, finance is a functionality, marketing is a functionality. So if you want various functionality, the best solution for go for any type of client in the world is go with Oracle. Like, I can say that even though others have, this is one of the best platform that you know, they can deliver those business functionality. Coming to the utilization, yeah, Oracle won't provide for, unfortunately, they won't give services for small organization. Minimum of 1,000 employees, and I can say at least the sales of $10 million is needed, then only the Oracle go for offering the service. Because you know, beyond that, if they go, it's like, how can I say, like, you are having a big truck and you are putting a small amount of weight which a auto can carry, like, you know, a small auto can carry. So that's how the comparison is. So that is the reason Oracle won't go for small organization. As I told that, you know, they have this strong presence in finance, supply chain management, SEM, supply chain management, marketing, sales, HCM means human capital management, right? So this is what the comparison. If you go for other ERP, they have their own, you know, can say advantage, or I can say own, can say there's a sales point advantage with them. But though they have many advantage, they have a limited functionality offerings. If you take a SAP or a, can say, you know, Google Cloud as an example, they are not very market leaders in finance and consulting. They are not the market leaders in supply chain. But Google Analytics are good in marketing and sales, but they are not good in HCM, like human capital management. If you take an example as a workforce, they are good in human capital management, but they are not good in finance or supply chain. So SAP is mainly for supply chain management. I can say anybody who works in the SAP, they are very specialized in the supply chain management and the marketing though, but they are not very good in finance and HCM. But if you take an overall example, Oracle Cloud provides, you know, you can say a fantastic experience to manage all these functionalities. And so this is a kind of a, you know, then comes, hold on. I was missing some, yes. So this is just, I can say, overview of a organization and its products, right? You know, this is take the slides just to present the example, how the companies manage their products, their operations, their human resource management, their financial functionalities. Right. If you take, can say Nestle's example, it has, can say Nestle as a, can say, organization has n number of brands. For example, it's mentioned that KitKat is one of the product of them, right? Or I can say a product brand of them, or you can say if you take an example as a P&G, Procter & Gamble, Tide is one of the things. So every organization has many number of products to maintain. Like, you know, you can say one day of P&G sales itself will cross, or you can say their product will sell 10 lakhs in number. So how come this can be managed efficiently? You cannot see, for example, if Procter & Gamble, P&G is selling, leave that example, take a Coke as example, you're just buying the Coke. So take assume the I can say that this picture. The people here in 136 crores of India, they'll also consume the coke. Like not all, I can say 10% if you take. People in USA consume coke. People in Middle East consume coke. So these many cokes and the related products will sell, right? So when they want to buy the coke, they won't see coke alone can't manufacture. They buy from some of the supplier who take their formulas or technology and produce the coke, right? So they want to manage n number of suppliers who supply the coke bottle to the Coca-Cola, right? And Coca-Cola itself will distribute to n number of distributors across the globe, right? And when buying the supply from the supplier, Coke will give money to them to buy the product, and when Coke sell the product, they get the money. So you assume that how much number of products will sell, how much number of transactions will come. So you cannot do manually in a paper or a pen, or you can't do it in a kind of Excel sheet, right? If your organization, if your functionality, if your sales are in a small number, then you can manage those things effectively without IT solution or without ERP. But when the number of products is more, when your presence is more across the globe, then you need to go with that. I mean to say, this Oracle Cloud, understand, especially Oracle Clouds is designed to understand all the functionality of the business, and it will understand the business models across the organization, across the globe. So whatever type of organization, take example, the best example is Indian Army use their servers as Oracle ERP. Their ERP is nothing but our Oracle is the ERP they use. Even they can say, the Fortis hospital chain used the Oracle as their ERP to manage their the daily services that they maintain there. So I mean to say, there are two parts in the ERP management. One is the business model and the functionality. Second can be technology part. I'll discuss the technology part in the coming slide. So this is how the business model works. And if you if you deep down how the business works, so this is the exact offering that Oracle as a fusion will offer it. They offer finance. Inside the finance, they further offer this type of account payables, accounts receivables, and accounts payables is nothing but, for example, you pay something and you get the product. So that we call as account payable. Account receivable is you sell them product and you get the money back. So that is nothing but the account receivable. So like this, more than 140 functionalities are maintained by the Oracle. This, the further slides I will tell how a technology can help to enhance that business process effectively in the Oracle model. So here comes, so as I discuss what is Oracle is, and then what is Oracle's business model is, how then it can come to the technology and other things. The business that the model that I am working with is, I have KPMG will buy the Oracle product. Okay, Oracle is our, Oracle is our vendor. We buy the product, we go to the client, we see what the client business is, what are the types of business the client do, what is the functionality that the client needs, and then we come to the Oracle, the cloud. This is the thing, high level. So here I need to say that there are four terms used in consulting industry. If you go to any consulting industry, they use this four term again and again. One is advisory. Advisory is nothing but the high level reporting of an overall project or overall business things. That we call this a advisory. Right? And then comes the functional. As I mentioned it already, functional is nothing but you understand the organization, you understand the business process of organization. So that is a functional. Next comes the engineers, that you guys part. So when you are recruited in a consultant firm who is doing the Oracle consulting, then you will be mostly in initial days or years, you'll be working into two functionality, technical and integration. So how this advisory and function happens, this technology people will use the technology, your coding skills, your programming skills, so that the backend, whatever the backend operations which is happening will be maintained. Like consider that you have a customer is paying for me. In backend, you register that this customer is paying this much of amount at this time for so and so, right? So those will be registered by the technical person. Oracle normally works in the table format. So whatever the information that you gather will be there in the form of a tables. Okay, so that is normally a technical part will do, and the conversions. So the conversion part will be explained later, right? Conversion is nothing but if you are converting a data from one system to another, then we call that as a conversion here, right? And then comes the integration part. Integration is open word. It comes in the mathematics, it comes in the software industry, it comes in consulting too also. In Oracle Fusion, we call integration means it's nothing but you are triggering a regular operation in a regular interval of time. So how you make the process or the operation automated, we call this integrations. Where in software industry, they call that terms are different. Many softwares, they collide to form a solution. They call this integration. In Oracle Fusion Consulting, we call integration is a automated process of the regular interval of time. So this is how the function, how the Oracle and how the Oracle business works and how technology people can help them. So the next slide, yeah. So this is how the, a slide of a Oracle tool. So as I told, you are given a URL, okay, web-based URL. You are given a ID for that. For example, Sivakumar123, and there is a password for that, FX123. So that if you go, then this screen will come. So this is the front-end screen of the Oracle. It's not mandatory. The screen should be always been there. Based on the customer usage, based on the customer need, we customize the screen. In this screen, you can say a product management is there, manufacturing is there, costing is there. Automotive producer like Mahindra and Mahindra, they will be dealing mostly with manufacturing. They may be dealing with the product. So their screen looks like this. If you take the example, as I can say, ICICI as a banking service, they work with normally the financial models. So their screen will be like accounts payable, accounts receivable, cash management, or a fixed asset, and so on. So this is a customized screen. So this is how the screen looks like, how the functional screen, right? So this functional screen normally mostly handled by the people who, normally the functional part of any operation be handled by the people who have studied the MBA. So that's how I get into the organization. I already have experience of studying the MBA from the reputed college. Then there I have the experience of working in the Amazon web services, AWS, because we have a project on that. So that is how when the interview comes, that I present myself there and then I get into that. So normally as an MBA guy or a functional guy, you can say that I normally, my daily life is I'll go here, I manage operations, whatever happens here. My client will say I need this and this, so I just manage this page, right? Next comes the technology. That means the techies, the people who are going to complete or studying the engineering, especially in this CS background, their job when they come into the organization, it's not only like KPMG or something like that. If you go to the Oracle Consulting, then your screen looks exactly right. So you can say this is the background operations, conversions, data migration happens. To support the functional or the business model, you people will be programming something here, right? So this is a typical screen that the technical persons will get it. Since the time constraint, I move to the next slides. I'll tell you how you program, like what is the logic that you have to do the programming. So, but this is basically the screens that looks like. And Oracle use tables and constraints as their the backend, and SQL and PLSQL is their programming language. Right, so here comes the conversions. Conversions. So this is one part the technology person will come and work when you go to the consulting, like especially the ERP consulting, cloud-based consulting, all through wherever you work on SAP, you work on Google Analytics, you work on Amazon web server, anywhere. This is how the typical operations that you do. Target database is nothing but conversions is nothing but, as I told, it will convert from one system to other system. Target system will be normally the Oracle, which that we provide the service. Conversions may be happens in the many forms. Consider that the I can say organization like you can say ICICI is using Tally as their ERP. Now they are moving to Oracle, because the reason is Oracle can Tally can manage only financial solutions. Oracle can manage financial and human resource. So as a bank, they have a lot of human resource. They have a human, they have a financial operation. So they are migrating that to here. So what they do, Tally as a, I can say we call this a old system or a legacy system in technical terms. From there, using a tool, I can say a middleman or a middleware tool, we convert all this data or all the operations or all the integration from here, and it will put it here. Right. So yeah, a technology guy will helps me. So now in my office, this is what I'll do. I sit in my table next to my technology person will be there. So I say, these are all the information that I need. I don't need every information of the old system. These are all the information that I need. You transfer it to here. So he use generally we use CCF. There is a tool there which is the conversion tool. That tool will take all the information from the old system or legacy system, and they put it here. So this is how the conversion process happens. Yeah. So there are two types of conversion normally happens. One is from a legacy system, and another one is from a source system. There are two types of conversion happens here. I'll tell you one, what is legacy and what is a source system. Legacy system is nothing but consider that your client is going to implement Oracle. Since they have a lot of issue with their old system, take example is Tally is old system. They are going to take all the information from Tally to Oracle, right? So this is the case. So we call Tally as a legacy, and our target model is Oracle, right? So normally, if you go to the Tally also has a certain formats. So it is I can say their data are also structured, right? Only there is a difference between a data. Tally may maintain them in the constraints. Oracle may mention it in the table, so that is only different. But the data were very structured in the legacy system, and here also it is structured. So it is nothing but a structured data format to a structured data format. We will do the migrations, right? So that's how if you are trying to move from one system to another system, the legacy system is so structured, and the Oracle is also structured. So and how it moves, I'll tell you that. Here you can see a terminal FBDA, right? Normally for the migration, we use this FBDA files, file based data import files. How that looks, that is nothing but a, this is how it looks like. So this is like the, how the tables looks like. You can see there is a item number is nothing but a, product will be there. There is a organization name will be there. Their descriptions will be there. And many informations will be there, like what is a, these are all more functional part. So what is their, for example, a product known as Ashirvad Atta, take an example as that, which is produced by ITC. There each product has each product number, like this is normally mentioned on the date or other formats. So these all the information there, they have a, these all the information there in the old system. Now we have to migrate that to the new system. So what will we do? The tool will capture exactly the information in this, in Excel, which is in the table format, right? All the informations are captured, and then you can say that then those things will be migrated from this legacy to this. So this FBDA is a file which I shown, the Excel sheet, that is a conversion tool that helps us to migrate that from the system. Those files are converted into FBDA file. That Oracle will accept those file, and then it will be loaded in the system. So typically, using the programming and other things, you helps to, you helps us to maintain all those things using your, technology knowledge. So this is how, as I say that, this is the front end screen. For example, if I was, if I was entering an item or a product, so item has a name, it has a description, it has a class, it has a status and other thing, right? So if I go here, I have to click here product management, then this screen will appear. I can enter the data and I can close it. So in one time I can produce only one item information. But if I use this data, you can see the same item name, number is there, same description is there, same, I can say, item class is there, and same, all the information will be there. You can produce n number of things. Even you can, one at the time, using this file, you can load 1 lakhs item also. Maybe not even 1 lakh. You can load 10 million, 1 million item also at a time. But using this, you can enter only one. So here is where the technology people comes into play. They manage even, maintaining, working in the Excel is also is a kind of a, tedious task. Technical people will help us to, do this thing. So that is the reason whenever in the entry point of view, Excel is one of the most important tool, because 1 million or 10 million number of information can be easily filled in Excel, and Excel can go in any type of software, any type of ERPs. I can say softwares, you can say in ERPs. So learning Excel is, I can say, one of the best skill in your academic years before the interviews or before entering into your industry, you have to excel with, right? So so next, if you go with the next slide, next comes. So this is from the source system. Initially we say there is a legacy system. Legacy system is a one system, it's a fixed system. Source system is a different system. Consider that like Amazon is buying, Amazon is selling mobile phones also, Amazon is selling dresses also, right? So Amazon has a supplier who send a mobile phone, their information will be in the form of some other format, right? And it has a other one system which will procure garments. So they have the different formats, right? Source system is nothing but where you are sourcing the things and how that information can be converted into this Oracle, right? This guy maintain Excel sheet, this guy maintain Notepad, this guy may maintain a Word format for their thing. So how can that can be converted into Oracle? There comes the big data migration or a conversion techniques will come. Generally, whatever the source system, they have a format, we convert that into a FBDA format, standard formats. There is a conversion tool there. That tool converts, filters every information, convert that and put it in the FBDA format. FBDA format is nothing but this format. And then wherever it maybe comes, we convert that in this form and we will send that to Oracle. So that Oracle can produce n number of products at one go using these techniques. Now generally, source systems data are not structured. The tool, like you engineers, what they will do, you know this unstructured data. Generally, you convert that unstructured data into a structured one. Alright, so that's where the task will be. There are many, conversion tools that are there which converts unstructured data into structured data using certain programming skills that you already learned. You normally used to do the operation sheet. So this is how the typically the operation happens. Next slide. Next comes the relationship database management. So this is kind of I believe the participants who have been here may know, definitely know about this. This is one of the core area. If you want to come into a cloud-based consulting services, then as an engineers or software engineers, then you should be very clear about this one, like how the relationships works with that, right? So this is a typical kind of a small operation that just for an example that I make it here. This is nothing but relationship database management is nothing but flow of information, how the logical flow is. Like if you say here, you are maintaining an Excel sheet in the class ID, the next is going to be, here you can say in the table 2, the class ID is there, next it is going to be in the table 1. So how this relationship happens? Generally, people use SQL, normally I can say, in ERP, many will be using SQL under program SQL to establish this relationship database management, right? So here you need to understand the logic. It's not only that you're an engineer that you have to do only the programming. Before programming, you have to understand the logic. Like there are certain supplier is there. The supplier is sending a product to you. So you need to know, you have to write some logic for the product. In the return, you are giving back the money to them. So you need to know some part of a financial part, some part of the supply chain management, some part of operations and everything. So if you know that logic, then using that programming skills, you can easily manage this relation data management. Yeah, next comes the integration. I didn't write anything in the slide. The reason for that is the best way to they explain ERP integration is nothing but it is a process. As I told you before, if you go to this slide, it's clearly mentioned that it's a process of automating the process with the regular interval. So if you come back to this, at a regular interval of time of 31st or the 1st, every employee in any organization will receive salary, right? So to automate this process, we use the technique known as integration. What we'll do, we program the tables or can say our transactional business intelligence in such a way that in every 31st, if there is a 31st date, you pay the salary, you initiate the salary for this. Or in the can say if the month has only 30 days, initiate the salary on 30th day. So those process every time we will not do. Once you program that thing in Oracle, Oracle can do this thing for n number of employees and n number of human resource. So that's where the human resource management will come. Every month at 31st, it initiate a process, it will automatically credit the salary to all the employees. So this is a typical example that I'm saying as an integration technique. So integration is nothing but in regular interval, you do some process so that the process is automated. So what will you do? As a engineers, you go, you can write the program. If it is a 31st on January, then do so and so. Or you put a if loop and you have to write that. Same thing, if February has only 28 days, then you have to write that program for that. If it is a leap year, then if it is 29 days. So this, automating the projects is known as, you can say, integration techniques, right? This is how a typical screen looks like, right? You can say there are two types of process happens. One is the static data and a dynamic data, which in the form of the tables. Static is nothing but consider that I'm logging in this screen. This is nothing but the static data. I can see only the screen. So there are backend tables for everything. If you take example as services, right? For this service, there is a backend table which will be written some coding on that. So those code will be displayed as a services here. When you come further, the dynamic table, if you go into the service, if you go into the product management, if you create a item here, and go here and save, then the item will be created. So there is a process that happens, right? So those will be, we can call this a dynamic tables, we call them, right? So I believe the software engineers, through your academies, you may learn those things. I'm just brushing up these things. As I told, each whenever the operation happens, these tables, every time the tables will be hit and the transition will happen. So how you do, using this programming, you normally do this, right? This is nothing. Whenever simply logically can say for the static table, you can use SQL, normal SQL. But for the dynamic tables, if you want to process the table, then programming SQL is needed, right? For example, if we take example, there is another one, Excel also. I can say that's the best case I can move forward. This is the case that I have been mentioning. If Amazon is buying, the iPhones from a certain vendors, like 1, 2, 3, right? How the dynamic table will looks? Consider that the vendor, Apple India, Bangalore, Apple India, Chennai, and Apple India, Delhi, are three are sending some information to the Oracle, right? Oracle need to find who is the best person to do this, right? So what we'll do, we form rules, validation rules we call, assignment rules we call. We assign those ranks to this vendors. Based on this ranking, we accept their products or their services or their data. Like, so if three of them send this data, I tell the Oracle, rank one, Bangalore is the first one, right? Rank two, once this process is completed, then rank this two and rank this three, then the operations will go in this sequence. So this is where the programming SQL will come. In this program, using the program SQL, you rank, like, you know, you create a programming to ranking the vendors in certain form so that my process will become very efficient. I don't want to tell every time my employee that receive this. I tell my database management receive whichever come first from the Bangalore, even right second from Chennai and third from Delhi. So here where those programming SQLs will come into the play, right? So I think that's all. So next come to the, since the time constraints, as I want to present this full as early as possible. So the future scopes and the conclusion is, yes, Oracle computing or can say cloud computing is going to be the future, because a lot of organizations, even I can hear the latest news that we have been reading through, there is a can say sharp increase of 20-25% of cloud based services demand in India, right? Because due to the COVID, people can't go to the organization and work, so they're making the process automated. They don't want to go to the offices, take the laptops or computer and connect from the server. They want that to be keep it in the cloud, so that the efficiency will increase. So that is the latest information. This is the information about the use already before this in this June quarter, there is a 21% of increases in the cloud-based services in the world market, like not only in USA, through the globe this increased because of this COVID situation. The advantage over this is you can log in as like you're logging in a Gmail and you do all the operations from a remote place, from the place where you are living itself. So that's a the scope that we have. And of course the future may be there is a collaboration with the artificial intelligence and the Internet of Things. So that may be the future scope that I along with the people who are working in the industry can see. So with that, I believe that I completed the presentation on time. So this is a reference slides that I used. And yes.
Thank you, Arun Prasad sir, for your valuable informative presentation. Yeah. And I ask the participants to clarify if you people have been having any questions to ask with.
Yeah, your questions are welcome. You don't want to be very professional or you don't want to be logical in your questions. Any type of question that you have, though from starting to how to attend the interview or what is that you want to study, that if you want to go into that, any types of questions are welcome.
And a question from myself, Arun Prasad sir.
Yeah.
The thing is that Oracle, in the sense, main ideology kept into our mind is that it is mainly used for the database purpose. But Oracle Fusion, if we have been maintaining a database, it has to be in a secured manner, isn't it? So, Oracle Fusion having the capability to provide security in which aspects? Just want to know that.
That's a welcoming one. The banks all through the globe, not only in India, all through the globe, hesitate to use cloud as their solution. The reason for that is, they feel that if they share their information in this cloud, because cloud is not a physical one, it's like a common thing. So there is a security breach there. There is a chance of security breach. They feel that, right? So this is throughout the globe, this is a big solution. This is a big doubt for all. See, consider that unlike the other servers, right? So these clouds are also protected using certain security solutions that makes this cloud as a very strong solution. Like you can put your data in a public cloud, you can put it in a data in a half private cloud, or you can put your cloud in a you can buy the cloud itself. Let's say either way it works. Through their IT security services, like what McKinsey and others provides, these clouds are also protected. They have a regular update of the security systems, and unlike the other service, there's no security breach happens till now. Especially this Oracle cloud-based services, we haven't have most of complaints are like there is a security breach happened. It is as like maintained how it is mentioned in the physical server. Like I'm not very technology sound about how the technical parts of the server works, but the security services like, you know, McAfee is a you know official security provider for the Oracle, so they program that so that the hackers can't enter that. You know, there are some highly secured passwords and other things so that, you know, hackers or any ethical hackers or whatsoever maybe can't breach the security very easily.
Thanks for the clarified information, sir. Okay, sir, let's wind up the session. It's time for the value tree. I thank our Almighty for making this event a grand success. And I also thank our SCAD Group of Institution Management, our Chairman Sir, our MD, and our GM Development for giving their constant support in organizing such webinars during this lockdown period. And I also thank our Principal Dr. V. Velmurugan and our HOD, Ms. Brinda Ma'am, for giving their constant support and valuable suggestions to make this webinar a grand success. And I also thank the resource person of today, Mr. Arun Prasad, for giving his informative presentation, and it's an eye-opener to all, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, Shubha. Thank you. Thanks a lot for all participants. Thank you.
And last but not the least, I thank all the participants for their patient listening and making this webinar happen today. Thank you all. Thank you, everyone.